Today we are going to use fabric to make a crane. Inflate 4 balloons leaving about 6-inch flat tail. I use different color balloons for this instruction. Twist the first yellow bubble. We are going to twist all bubbles of the same about 2-inch size. Twist the first gray bubble. Lock the free end of the first gray bubble with free end of the first yellow bubble. Now let's connect 2 more balloons. Twist the first red bubble. Twist the first pink bubble. Lock the free end of the first pink bubble with the free end of the first red bubble. Twist the second yellow bubble. Twist the second red bubble. Lock the free ends of the second yellow and second red bubbles in one lock twist. Okay, now twist the second pink bubble and twist the second gray bubble. Lock the free ends of the second pink and second gray bubbles in one lock twist. It is the bottom view of our sculpture. Twist the third pink bubble and twist the third red bubble. Lock the free end of the third pink and red bubble in one lock twist. Twist the third gray bubble and twist the third yellow bubble. Lock the free end of the third gray and yellow bubble in one lock twist. Alright, let's take a look on our sculpture. Basically, we are making the same fabric as we did in previously published instructions, fabric 2, fabric 3. The big difference here is that we connect both ends of each row in this sculpture. Twist the fourth yellow and the fourth red bubble. Lock the free ends of the fourth yellow and fourth red bubble in one lock twist. Twist the fourth gray and twist the fourth pink bubble. Lock the free end of the fourth gray and fourth pink bubble in one lock twist. Keep working in the same fashion. We can make as many rows as we want. In this example, we use only 4 balloons to build the tower. We can use any even number of balloons to build a larger in diameter tower. There is also no limit of how high you can make it. Just add balloons as you need it. Here is a time-saving way to make the sculpture. Hold and twist balloons together to make the bubbles and lock the ends in one lock twist in one move. Twisting different size bubbles will definitely distort the tower. Fix it right away. I have mentioned before that we can make the tower as tall as we want. Let's limit ourselves here for this instruction. So far we have twisted 6 rows or 6 bubbles of each color. Now we have to build a cabin on the top of the crane tower. We can make different size bubbles to make the cabin in different ways. Let's do it in the simplest way. Twist bubbles of the same about 2-inch size. Twist a chain of 2 pink bubbles. Twist a gray bubble. I didn't twist 1 pink bubble. Okay, now we're good. Lock the free end of the 7th gray bubble with the free end of the 8th pink bubble. Twist the 7th yellow and the 8th gray bubble. Lock the free end of the 7th yellow and 8th gray bubble in one lock twist. Twist the 8th yellow and the 7th red bubble. Lock the free end of the 7th red and the 8th yellow bubble in one lock twist. Twist the 8th red bubble. Lock the free end of the red 8th bubble between the 7th and the 8th pink bubbles. It's important to make this connection working in the same direction around the row. Changing the direction will result in making different shape. We will talk about it in separate instruction. Or just explore it on your own. We made the base of the cabin, here's the top view, the front view, the side view. Here's the bottom view. We have to fix the bottom a little bit later. First we will finish the cabin. Again, there are various way to do it. Let's twist 9 bubbles of each color. And we lock 3 ends of 9 bubbles in one lock twist. It is a way to make one of the simplest cabins. Congratulations! We have made the crane tower with a cabin. We can cut off the rest of the balloons, or we can use remains of the balloons to decorate the tower. Let's just make some funny tails. Twist about 2-inch bubble at the end of each balloon and force the bubble to the very end of the flat tail. Do it with all 4 balloons. I know, it doesn't look like a crane now. Some silly sculpture. Anyway, we are going to improve it now. We are going to use one more balloon to make the crane's arm. Inflate a balloon. I use a brown balloon, leaving about 8-inch flat tail. Oh, I forgot to mention, not for this sculpture, but with regards to many other sculptures, we can use technique described in this instruction to wrap balloon in balloons. Now let's fix the crane's arm, just for the brown balloon through both sides of the cabin. That is the simplest crane's arm. Again, we can make a funny tail. It will represent the hook. Let's make this bubble up to 1-inch size. This time, I'm going to tie a knot to secure the funny tail at the end of the balloon. It is a necessary precaution because my youngest son will play with this crane. As we all know, all unlocked bubbles doomed to be deflated in hands of little kids. Here I twist 2 small soft bubbles and lock all ends of those 2 bubbles in one lock twist. Actually, I twist 1 bubble, lock both ends and split the bubble on 2 bubbles. In any ways, it would look the same. It looks ridiculous. However, we need those 2 bubbles to keep the rope, the wire, the cable, whatever it is, in a fixed position. So here's a crane's arm with a hook. Let's attach it back to the cabin. Congratulations again, we have made the crane. The crane will look much better and have much more use if we put the crane on a base. So let's make a base. Inflate a balloon leaving about 3-inch flat tail. Twist a chain of 4 about 2-inch size bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 4 bubbles in one lock twist. The rest of the balloon we split to make 4 about 7-inch size bubbles. Twist the 5th 7-inch bubble. Lock the free end of the 5th bubble between the first and the second bubbles. Twist the 6th 7-inch bubble. Lock the free end of the 6th bubble between the 2nd and the 3rd bubble. Twist the 7th 7-inch bubble. Lock the free end of the 7th bubble between the 3rd and the 4th bubble. If you properly measure previous bubbles, then the rest of the balloon is the 8th 7-inch bubble. It's okay if we make an 8th bubble of a different size. Lock the free end of the 8th bubble between the 4th and the 1st bubble. Congratulations, we have made the base for the crane. Our next step is obvious. We attach the crane tower to the base. There are four ends at the bottom of the tower. We tie each end to the appropriate spot between bubbles of the base. Again, if you made a different size 8th bubble of the base, then you want to place the 8th bubble of the base on the front or on the back side of the crane. Congratulations, we have made the crane on the base. Let's just fix all bubbles in proper positions. The structure of crane base allowed us to convert the crane to sort of a mobile crane. Simply adjust position of the sides of the base to make two wheels mobile crane. There is no problem to convert it back to the flat base. Use a permanent black marker to draw the face. You can do it on front side of the base or front side of the cabin. Two eyes, nose, big smile. Simple drawing. Okay, I'm going to cut off funny tails from the top of the crane tower. It would make the sculpture simpler and our crane more recognizable. Here is a crane with one funny tail on the top. Instead of funny tails on the top of the crane, I'm going to twist soft about 1 inch bubble. Lock both ends of this bubble in one lock twist. Cut off the rest of the balloon. This bubble covers all the knots we have made on the top. Congratulations, we have made the crane. In this instruction, we use different color balloons to make the crane. Here is an example of a crane tower made of four green balloons. You may notice some minor differences in this sculpture. The crane's arm has extra bubble. The cabin is different as well. I added an extra row of bubbles to the green tower and the green cabin. Here is the side view. Here's the top view, the front view. Usually I don't use black marker to make any drawings on dark color balloons. It is just wasting of your time. Let me show it to you. Black is hardly visible on a dark background. Anyway, let's finish the face. We can use technique described in this instruction to make large scale sculptures or parts of large sculptures. For example, we can use it to make a torso, a leg, an arm, a cake, a vase, a hat, and so on. Have fun and happy twisting!